wasn't the first time that God and Moses were on the mountaintop. They've been up there quite a few times. Maybe not all the way to the top, but they've been there. You remember, God came along and he said, Moses, I need you to do something for me. Your people are enslaved, and I need you to take care of getting them out of there. You might remember that Moses didn't exactly jump up and down and go, yeah, yeah, I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm with you, I'm with you. No, no, no. Now, that wasn't Moses' way. He said, yeah, you know, I don't think so. That's not the job I've been given. That's not the job I want. And they went back and forth. And Moses was not going to have his way, but he kept trying. And he said, so, you know, if you tell me your name, maybe that will help me convince the people that I've been sent by the right person. And God responds, I am who I am. Now that's not going to help. Moses out of all that, is it? What kind of circular thinking is this? But he actually goes and does it. And over time, over many plagues, Moses is able to lead the people out of Egypt and into, oh yes, the promised land. It wasn't. God didn't lead the people out of slavery into the promised land. God led people out of Egypt into the wilderness. Oh, great. And you remember the stories we've been reading them. The people are tired, the people are hungry, the people are thirsty. Moses, how could you lead us out of Egypt in order to have us die? Well, Moses went and talked to God. And God helped them create community by giving them some idea of the way to care about each other and care about God. God gave Moses the commandments. And no sooner had the people been given the commandments than Moses goes back up the mountain, and what happens? He's gone too long. You know, with that 40 days thing, that number we use when it's a long time, 40 days. He's gone for a long time, and they don't know. They don't know what's going on, and so immediately they go to Aaron, and they say, so Aaron, Moses is and we haven't seen God, so why don't you make us a golden calf? Aaron, not being the best of leaders, immediately collects all the gold and turns it into a golden calf. And God sees what's going on because Moses is still on the mountain with him, and he says, Moses, look what your people are doing. I am so angry. I'm just going to wipe them all out. And Moses, in this intimate relationship with God, says, you can't do that. You can't destroy the people that you've saved. You can't, I mean, what are the people in Egypt going to say? They're going to point to you and they're going to say, oh yeah, he made sure they got out of here to do what? To just put them right back where they were. So, God relented. God, who is in relationship with us, relented. God turned to the people and asked the people to turn to him. This journey that Moses has been on has been intriguing journey that gets him into close relationship with God. And you remember, we hear strands of different traditions. One of those traditions says that Moses and God met face to face, like this, intimately. And another says, you cannot see the face of God or you will die. Both of those are entwined here. So if anyone wants to tell you that the story only has one message, you better just say no, that's not true. Sometimes the God we have is the God of creation, the God of out there, the God who will speak a word and the water is separated from the land and the sky is created and the sun and the stars are created and the moon is created. And sometimes the God that we need is the God that is with us, standing on the mountain or in the valley with us. Be the God that we need. And in today's text, Moses is on the mountain again with God for the last time. And God says, look out here. You can see forever. You can see to what we know as the Mediterranean Sea. You can see what we know as the north of Israel. You can see what we know as the Jordan River and the Dead Sea. You can see it all. Moses won't be going there. Moses doesn't make it to the promised land. He's been on this journey to help this people create a community, to be a community, and he doesn't go all the way with them. That's often the story, isn't it? If there's anything worth striving for, if there's anything worth doing, probably won't actually get there. But we keep going, don't we? We keep going. We don't hear an argument in this text, which is kind of unusual. Really? Moses isn't going to fight back and say, come on! All this time you won't let me? No. He gets it. His work is done. The work isn't done, but his work is done. And so, this is where he ends this part of the story. And the people go on. Do what the people are called to do. God calls each of us to do our work. And to know when it's over. To know when we've done enough. God and Moses are standing on the top of the mountain, and it's time. You and I are standing at the top of the mountain, and we know it's time. And there will be a future, and there will be more work, and the work will go on, as you will go on. God stands on the mountain with each of us. Whether you need the God that says a word and the worlds are put into being, or you need a God who's right here in your heart, God will be who you need God to be. We will go on.